Hey, Kevin, why are you looking at us like that?
Because somebody's sleeping out there. I've had several questions here lately about shielding gas. How come I have to use two different bottles, you know, one for TIG and one for MIG? How come I can't use the same gas on different machines? How come I have to have different gases to do different processes or work on different metal? Okay, let's talk about shielding gas again. So I got this cute little bottle here. I bought this one a while ago when I was working with my Miller 251 MIG welder, and I was working on a piece of stainless, a sculpture made out of stainless. This is actually a tri-mix, so it's argon, carbon dioxide, and helium. They added that helium in there because it helps with penetration, and it helps to cut down on porosity. You know how much I hate porosity. So normally it would have the mix, it would have the percentage of mix written on here, but this poor little bottle is so old that the pen marks have just faded away to nothing. But if you go to wherever you get your bottles filled, if you're going to work with stainless MIG welding or aluminum MIG welding, and just tell them you want tri-mix, argon, carbon dioxide, helium. Great mix for doing this kind of work with a MIG. So now with the TIG welder, straight argon, nothing else. That's all you need, straight argon. Because of the way the TIG process works, you can get away with just using this gas, and you change your filler rod, whether it's steel or stainless. Nope, where'd it go? Sorry. Stainless or aluminum, you can get away with the same gas. But when you go to your MIG and you're just doing steel, then you're going to want argon and carbon dioxide, commonly called MIG gas. MIG gas. It's a two-part mix, as opposed to the three-part mix. But this works the best with just plain old steel. There's tons of different kinds, different mixes, different percentages. It all depends on what you're doing. It all depends on what you want to get out of the weld. You can add a little helium, like in the tri-mix, get a little better penetration, a little less porosity. But there's a drawback, because with the helium, it takes a little more power. It's a little hotter, so you have a little more problem with burn through. So you got to be a little more careful with what you're doing. So you're going to want to use that with a thicker metal rather than a thinner metal. It's like, oh my God, there's so many different kinds. There's so many different variations on it, whether it's, you know, just a straight bottle like argon, or a dual mix like the argon and carbon dioxide, or a tri-mix. And then you get all the different percentages, whether it's, you know, 20% argon and 20% of this and 90% of that, and oh my God, it just gets it's incredibly, incredibly complex. That's why we got the guys at the gas store where they fill the bottles. They can help you with that. You got the guys at the welding store. You know, they can give you advice on that. Or do like I did. Good old Wikipedia. Just jump on here, type in shielding gas or welding gas or inert gas. You get tons and tons of information on here. You got the world's biggest library sitting right on your desktop. Jump out here, take a look. It answers a lot of questions for you. Makes it, when you get to welding, makes you a better welder, gives you a better job, a better finish. You spend less money because you get the right kind of gas the first time. Hope that helps. We'll see you again.